As we have embarked on this journey to Bethlehem, let us dwell on the passage for today's meditation, Matthew chapter 1 verses 1 to 17, which lists the genealogy of Jesus Christ our Lord. I would like to present my thoughts on family lineage and upbringing. Whenever we consider a marriage proposal, the family background is taken into consideration. That plays a major role in helping us to decide whether to go ahead or not. Unfortunately, we don't get to choose the family we are born into. But Jesus had the option. He could even have chosen who should be included in his lineage. However, we find all sorts of people are there in his genealogy. There are kings, shepherd, carpenter, prostitute, and there are people with a variety of characters. Some were good, some evil. There were Jews and Gentiles. Jesus chose ordinary people as his parents. Also, we notice in the genealogy that Josiah had sought the God of his father David, though his grandfather Manasseh and his father Amon had done evil in the eyes of the Lord. We notice that in our present day too. There are children who were born in ordinary families who have gone to achieve great success. At the same time, there are children who have gone wayward, though their parents may have been strong in their faith. This indicates that it doesn't actually matter who our parents are, and we don't have to blame our ancestors or our parents for our circumstances or anything that we are unhappy about. Nevertheless, we have privilege to choose our Heavenly Father. We have been given the spirit of sonship to call out Abba Father, as Paul writes in the letter to the Romans, chapter 8, verse 15, and also in Galatians chapter 4. We have a Father who knows us better than we know ourselves and loves us more than our earthly parents. Let us look up unto our Heavenly Father and try to emulate Him in our lives and our journey on this earth. As this is an initiative of the Seviga Sangam, how can I not ponder on the women mentioned in the genealogy of Jesus Christ? There are four women mentioned: Tamar, Rahab, Ruth, and Bathsheba, though she is mentioned as Uriah's wife. Tamar had to dress up as a prostitute to get her rights from Judah. Rahab, we don't know what caused her to become a prostitute. Ruth became a widow at a very young age and had to take care of herself and her mother-in-law. Bathsheba was taken by David, though she was the wife of Uriah, and she lost her husband too, as David wanted her. We find that all these women were wronged and subjected to unpleasant situations. But these women still find a mention in the genealogy of Jesus Christ. In these present pandemic times, there are many women who have been subjected to domestic violence and sexual abuse due to the lockdown with no one to help. But we can trust in our Heavenly Father to work in these worst circumstances to provide deliverance from these difficult times. All these people mentioned in the genealogy journeyed towards Bethlehem to bring into this world Jesus Christ to be our Savior. Whether they were good or bad, whether they were Jews or Gentiles, whether they were wrong or wronged. Likewise, let us also journey to Bethlehem to meet our Savior. Doesn't matter how we have been in the years gone by, let us look ahead to the star that rose in Bethlehem to lead us in the days to come, so that one day when the names are called out, we too find our name in the lineage of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for sending your Son into this world for us and thereby giving us this privilege to call out to you, Abba Father. You have placed us in the families you knew which are best for us. Help us to discern the purpose of our lives, our relationship with our family members and those around us. Use us and mold us as your child. We also pray for those women suffering from domestic violence and abuse during this lockdown. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.